Hi my red velvet cupcakes, welcome to this video, thank you so much for clicking on it. If you're returning to my channel then it's great to see you again, but if you're new then my name's Nicole and today I'm going to be doing the highly requested Notion tutorial slash tour video. So I am not like an absolute Notion expert, I'm sure that there's still things that I can learn, but I definitely can use it enough where I basically put like everything on it, like everything post year 11, my life is on Notion, and I use it for my year 12 flashcards slash notes, and they've worked so well that I'm definitely going to carry them on into year 13. The way that I'm going to split up this video is, first of all, I'll talk about Notion and what I use it for, and then I'll show you how I use it for school, and then actually show you how to make it like I do. So I have my laptop with me. Ooh, guys, look at my stickers. They're so pretty, I love them. It was so fun to make them. And so I guess I'll start screen recording my laptop now. So along the side here are my main pages. So I have my home, which is just my main to-do list. I have school, academic, which is things that are basically like for my personal statements. So things that aren't my school notes, but are related to school. And then bits and bobs are just random things that I've just made like a page for in Notion and I just stick it in there. My geography NEA, YouTube stuff, things that I've manifested, and then summer. I probably moved summer into bits and bobs, so that's in there now. And this is really handy, like you can add a page inside, you can duplicate, rename, move to trash, whatever. And you can like open it up as well, so you can see what's inside too. So this is what my Notion basically is. Okay, so this is like the school page, and this is where I have my notes. So as you can see at the top, there's like this banner thing. You can change it by choosing whatever is here, or you could upload something from your like laptop itself. Pinterest is obviously a great place, and then you can reposition it as well. So my covers are all Monet themed because I love Monet. Claude Monet is my fave. And then here you can like add an emoji. And what I do is usually when I'm bored, I'll just close my eyes and just scroll down through here and pick a random one. So this is the product of my last bored scrolling. And then this is just my school, and I can show you my flashcards. So I do biology, chemistry, geography. Let's go geography. So I always have my exam board specification linked at the top, so that's really easy for me to just... Okay, what the heck? Okay, so let's not go into geography flashcards. Let's go into biology flashcards. Okay, so Edexcel's slacking. So this is what my flashcards basically look like. So I have the main... Hang on. If I show you, if we go subject content, these are the 8 main topics, and then that corresponds with my... Ooh, okay, I didn't finish making them, but this is like, these first 4 are like AS, year 12, done. So let's go into like genetic information. So if we then go to the specification, genetic information, so this is, I use this as an example for my last video, but here I'll just explain it a bit more. So the specification is like statements that they give. So here it's like in prokaryotic cells, da 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 da. And then I will turn that into a question in here. So what are DNA molecules like? And then here's the answer, which corresponds to this statement in the specification. So I do word for word to the specification because that is what the exam answers will look like. And so as you can tell, like this is like the subtopic here, and then that is like the subtopic here, if that makes sense. So all of these questions are linked to this chunk here. So that's how I use Notion as my notes because it covers everything on the specification, but they're kind of in flashcard form. And yeah, so this would be the next one too. And then one thing that I do is if there is something, so with biology, I'm not too sure about other subjects, but it's like, it's typical to get like a 5 marker on one like area that you can kind of like plan beforehand in a way. So here, like structure of tRNA, I've put 5, and that means that there are 5 points I need to remember. So okay, why do I keep making mistakes? Okay, so 4, I'll change it like that. And then like you can add pictures here as well. So that is how I use Notion in terms of my flashcards. And so now let's like actually make a Notion page, and I'll show you what it's like. So here we can get the page on the big bit, if that makes sense. Let's just call this like Notion tutorial. And so with Notion, the forward slash key is your best friend. So I press the forward slash key and everything comes up. So you can add a page, and then you like with Notion, you can make so many rabbit holes. So this is like another page. And if we go back, that is the main page. And then this is like another page. And you could do like a page in here and a page in here if you really wanted to and keep going. Let's do another thing. So I'm just scrolling through, and like you can see what things you can put in Notion. Like you can genuinely use Notion for everything. And one thing that I think is so great is that it's basically like Microsoft Word, except it's, you can access it online, you can get it on a website. It's not like with Word where you have to go and find where you saved that document, because I'm really bad at saving documents for some reason. Like I always take ages to find one. And also if you save it on your laptop but you're on a computer at school, then you won't be able to like access that. So with Notion you can always access it as long as you have internet. So yeah, like you can add everything. So you can add to-do lists, you can like type something. So let's say for example I need to do geography, oh god, NEA. And then when you press the enter button, it will just automatically make another one. But if you press it again, then it will delete it. And then you can go and like type whatever. And one thing that's cool about to-do buttons is that you can just take it off like that. And then if you want to delete it, you can just press those 6 like dots there, delete. So this is how I would make my actual notes. So I would write toggle. And then typically the first heading, so let's, I can't think of anything. Let's just say biology. And then in here, I would then write toggle, and then I'd go into my list. So I'd say like question 1, question 2, I don't know. I can't think of anything right now. And then here, then I can start writing the information. And then it's great because that's why it's like flashcards, because you have to open it up. And then if you do the dash button and then space, that's a really quick way to get a list. And then you could say like answer 1, answer 2, and everything. You can like just copy and paste a picture, stick it in there as like a diagram, whatever. And oh, another thing that I think is really cute, this is just so random, but if you do a dash and then the larger than, that makes like a cute little arrow, which is nice as well. And so yeah, you could do like headings by size, you could add a table, which is quite handy too, and then expand it horizontally or expand it vertically as well. And like shrink it, like that. And then if you want to delete, you can just press those 3 dots, delete again. So let's see what else we can do. We could create a numbered list. We could do quotes and dividers. And yeah, like literally the possibilities are endless on Notion. You could do everything, images, audios, files. Tables. Yeah, and like absolutely just keep experimenting because there's so many things that you can do on here. Like, I'm scrolling through now and you can really tell. Yeah, you can add emojis. I thought it said Sigma. Whimsical. Oh, I love being whimsical. Okay, now I'm scrolling too far. But yeah, Island is quite useful sometimes as well. Although I do prefer. So if we say new calendar, then you can just add stuff in here. Let's say YouTube video. Today is the 7th. And then that's there. I use paper calendars. I'm not a big fan of online ones, but that's something that you can do as well. And yeah, there's just, I keep saying it, but like genuinely, there's so much that you can do. It's like, let's take this page, add an icon, let's. Is that a shaver? A razor? Okay, so let's say we've got the razor emoji. That was random. And then here we can add a cover. Okay, I'm not making this up. Is that a fish? Okay, so this is our new page. We've got a razor and we've got a fish. And then I just say like, hey guys, thank you for watching this video. Say love you guys. I hope this was useful. And I'm trying to think, what else do I use it for? Oh, you could get dividers. And then you could put like another thing in here, like live with whimsy. I don't know. But yeah, and then say like I could take that, stick that into school. Then it'd be at the bottom of school. I could take that out, stick it back out there again. Like, you could just keep experimenting and experimenting. I know that this was quite like a spur of the moment thing where I was just like, okay, I'm gonna film the video now. I haven't really planned it out that well, but I hope that it was useful. I hope that you found it somewhat entertaining. The fish and the razor is actually making me giggle because that was so random. But yeah, love you guys, and I hope you have a great day.